This is a video about the revival process of a Regency TR1 radio in Brazil. Regency TR1 was the very first mass-produced transistor radio. According to Wikipedia, it was launched to the market in November 1954. It seems that there is a large demand for these radios in eBay, so they cost over $400. We are a modest radio collector and cannot afford for this. In a lucky day, however, we found a radio for a very good price in eBay. Obviously, it was not in good condition, but fortunately the seller provided very accurate photos of the radio, so we could have an idea about its physical damages. We noticed some cracks and chips in the cabinet, and, more important, the ferrite antenna was missing. As a positive aspect, there was no evidence of battery leakage, which is the real radio killer. Moreover, the leather case was in very good condition. We didn't think twice. We decided to take our chances and invited the radio to come to Brazil. By luck, the internet is plenty of links to this radio, so it was easy to find its schematic diagram as well as other useful information. Once the radio arrived, we started our work by trying to install a new ferrite antenna in the cabinet. We could not expect a high sensitivity for the radio, so the antenna was not a very critical component in this case. At first, we tried to assemble a ferrite antenna with the same original size, but we couldn't find a proper copper wire to make the coil. As a result, the antenna impedance was too low, rendering a very low sensitivity to the radio. Thus, we tested different antennas coming from scrapped radios. One of them provided enough sensitivity to the radio despite its smaller size compared to the original antenna. In the next step, we fixed the problem of the battery. The 22.5V battery is no longer available in retail, so it was replaced by a couple of 12V batteries found anywhere. We improvised a battery case by shortening the case of a cheap Chinese radio using AAA batteries, since its diameter is the same. The 12V batteries provided enough current to the radio. The radio was ready to be tested. We noticed that four capacitors needed replacement and changed them. We live in a small city and couldn't find axial capacitors, but we'll look for them in the future. Finally, the cabinet was restored with glue and some epoxy mass. Not a Michelangelo masterpiece, but a decent cabinet for its age.
At last, my love has come along. My lonely days are over, and life is like a song.
As a result of our work, the Regency TR1 came back to life again and demanded less than 1 second to speak loud and clear Portuguese. We can listen now to the two local stations and two stations from neighboring cities located 10 miles away. For a radio which was dead, it is performing well. We are glad to add this historical radio to our collection, despite its limitations and modifications. If you have to learn only one lesson from this video, learn this. Try to preserve history and never refuse shelter and aid to an old radio. Thank you for watching this video.